is still your president!
It's legal for them to count votes in Pennsylvania 2 days after the election on November 3rd?
Yes.
You're wrong. Go. I don't even want to talk to you.
I believe that Donald Trump won the election. I believe that they tried to steal the election.
Stop the Steal, a movement of Trump supporters that gained hundreds of thousands of followers online in the hours after the election, has inspired protests across the country.
The ballots that you said you saw are lying around the place or in trash cans or whatever, where are you hearing that from?
The videos are going viral everywhere. I've seen them on TikTok, I've seen them on Facebook, I've seen them on Fox News, I've seen them on the local news around my area.
I've seen too much pieces of different evidence so far that shows that at this point I would be okay with a revote.
Really?
Yeah, absolutely. When you have video footage of people taking bags of ballots and showing that they are for Donald Trump and lighting them on fire.
I helped write a fact check on CNN on that particular video. The election officials said that video has been going around for a few days. They are printout ballots. They're not real ballots.
You use the information of the election officials.
Somebody like me comes along, tries to research it, tries to fact check it, and then I fact check it. You'll come back and say, well, the election officials would say that.
But wouldn't they, though? That's the thing, though. Question everything, right?
You are not going to steal this election from us.
The video actually showed sample ballots, not real ballots. The video's assertion is false. But even the president's son tweeted it to his millions of followers. Election officials in Virginia, where the sample ballots were from, told CNN they had spent days trying to correct the online misinformation.
USA! 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 USA!
When we went to bed on election night, when they told us they stopped counting, we woke up and there was a vertical spike right for Biden. 130,000 votes approximately. That's when I knew there was a problem.
Now, as my buddy Steve Bannon says, if you're gonna lie, be believable about it. Because you do not have 138,000 votes come in and 135,000 of them come in for Biden.
This is what I think you guys might have been talking about on election night, Michigan, 138,000. This was from a website called Decision Desk HQ. They came out and they said, we messed up, there was an error in how votes came back and reported, yeah. And that's why there was this spike in the map.
Yeah.
But, you know, the election officials in Michigan then all confirmed to say, yes, there was this error, they are not real ballots, those ballots never existed.
President Trump himself even shared a post about the Michigan error. Twitter labeled his post as misinformation.
Are you concerned that just as how people on the left can fall for misinformation, that maybe sometimes you...
I'm very thorough with the information I look at. I have my opinions, obviously, but I'm not just going to go around retweeting blatantly false information or things that I believe that are just... It's just, I look at things that are suspicious.
Some people at the protest told us the delays in news outlets projecting a winner contributed to their belief that Biden stole the election.
Put America first, or else it's going to be America last. Stand together.
You don't think there's any way Trump could have lost?
No.
Really?
Yes. How do you go from almost losing 200,000 in 5 hours, you're down to 30,000 votes away from winning?
A lot of Democrats voted in the mail, they voted absentee, they voted before election day. And in a lot of states, those election day votes got counted first. That's why Trump had that early lead. And then once those other votes started getting counted, that is how Biden caught up and
so
overtook.
Where are all the Trump ballots that were mailed in? Why are we finding them laying around in different places?
But Trump was telling everybody not to mail it in, right? That's why there's so much more mail-in Democratic votes, no?
No.
Many of the false claims alleging voter fraud spread on social media. Facebook and Twitter labeled some as misinformation.
I think that's wrong. I think that's not their place. We're like one big science experiment for social media. If I'm seeking a certain viewpoint and they seem to see that I favor that viewpoint more, that's the viewpoint that they're going to feed me. And then the other side's going to get a different viewpoint.
Does that concern you as a Facebook user?
I mean, it concerns me, yes, because of the fact that unfortunately people fail to think for themselves. They feed into everything that they're seeing without questioning it.